In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
When the Lord comes, he will bring to light the things that are now hidden in darkness, and will disclose the purpose of and the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us confess our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy. You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, fill our hearts with your love, and as you revealed to us in angels the coming of your Son as man, so lead us through the sufferings, through the suffering and death, to the glory of your resurrection, for he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the prophet Micah. The Lord says this, "You, Bethlehem Ephrathah, the least of the clans of Judah, out of you will be born for me the one who is to rule over Israel. His origin goes back to the distant past, to days of old. The Lord is therefore going to abandon them till the time when he shall give birth. Then the remnant of his brothers will come back to the sons of Israel. He will stand and feed his flock with the power of the Lord, with the majesty of the name of his God. They will live secure, for from then on he will extend his power to the ends of the land. He himself will be peace." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Psalm 25. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me forth in your truth, for you are God my Saviour. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. Good and righteous is the Lord. He brings back those who stray. He guides the meek in his ways and shows his paths to the lowly. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. All his ways are mercy and truth for those who are faithful to his word. To those who love him, he reveals his mind and shows them all his will. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
A reading from the letter to Hebrews. This is what Christ said in coming into the world. You who want no sacrifice or oblation, prepare a body for me. You took no pleasure in the holocausts or sacrifices for sin. Then I said, just as I was commanded in the scroll of the book, God, here I am, I'm coming to obey your will. Notice that he says first, you did not want what the law lays down as the things to be offered, that is, the sacrifices, the oblations, the holocausts, and the sacrifice of sin, and you took no pleasure in them. And then he says, here I am coming to obey your will. He is abolishing the first psalter to replace it with the second. And this will was for us to be made holy by the offering of his body, made once and for all by Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. And
also
with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Mary set out and went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now, as the as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is this fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? For the moment your greeting reached my ear, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is the one. Blessed is the one who believes that the promise made by the Lord would be fulfilled. This is the Gospel of the Lord. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and of earth, and all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate by the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Power of the Spirit in union with the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the Church throughout the world, for our unity and peace, for our pastors, for Francis the Chief Bishop, for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, for Jonathan, our bishop. We pray for the life and witness of the Church throughout this parish. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
We pray for peace in the world. We pray for our own country, for Elizabeth, our Queen, our government and parliament, the leaders of all nations, that they may work together for truth and peace and justice. Lord, in your mercy,
Amen.
We pray for our local community, for all who live in this parish, for our own families, our neighbours, our friends, and all whom we shall meet in this new week. Lord, in your mercy,
Amen.
We pray for those in special need, for victims of disease, for those who care for them. We pray for those commended to our prayers, especially for Michael Villero, Sophie Nolan, Alden May, Edna Lee, Herman Bass, Bella Tatum, Lydia Chatterley, Alan Bailey, Bill Crosby, Mary Razor, John and Alan Razor, Luke Wibber, Alex Duncan, Evelyn Hatch, Matta, Tracy Clayton, Justina Ockram, Derek Skimmings, Carl Brooks, Marietta Thornton, for Rose, for Paul, for Terry Wheeler, for Dawn. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
We pray for those who have died recently, for Richard Martin, for Andy Atwood, those whose anniversaries fall at this time, may they know the light of the risen Christ. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. come for us, the brethren. Says you, Lord God of all creation, and through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God and Everlasting Father. He is the one who is the one foretold by all the prophets, whom the Virgin Mary bore with love and beyond all telling. John the Baptist was his herald and made him known when he came. In his love, Christ filled us with joy. As we prepare to celebrate his birth, so that when he comes again, he will find us watching in prayer. Which are beyond praise. And so with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim our Lord, give your glory, and join in the unending hymn of praise. Holy, 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 God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." the same way after supper he took the cup and gave you thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. In memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life, giving bread, this saving cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share the one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, St. Joseph, the Apostles, the Martyrs, St. Alphaeus, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, of honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Thou, O God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Help us to you. We thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and everything. The Lord be with
you.
Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you. Scatter the darkness from before your path and make you ready to meet him when he comes in glory. Bless you, God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and night.
Amen.
Go in peace of promise. Just two important notices before we all disappear. First of all, this evening we're going carol singing around the parish. We should be leaving here at about 6 and joining our friends around at the Annunciation, the Roman Catholic Church, at 6:30. Everyone's very welcome to come. If you live nearer the Annunciation than here, for heaven's sake, just come along to the Annunciation. If you live near here, we'll set off from here a bit after 6:00. That's the first thing. The second thing is that there will be an 8:00 Mass, as well as the Mass at 9:00 on Christmas Eve. There will be 8:00 Mass as usual, as well as an 11:00 Mass. And in just the same way, the following day, which will be next Sunday, there will be an 8:00 Mass as well as the 11:00 one. Anyway.